what we do now will benefit the future generations. So if we make an action now, if we make a change or improvement in ourselves, we will be able to influence others. It is a process. There will be birth pains on starting an activity. People will ridicule you, people will belittle you on what you are doing. But we shouldn't give up.
So nagbo-bloom na po yung tourist dito sa La Union. Sabi nga nila, it's good but it's bad kasi nga po yung epekto ng situation gaya ng pollution. So na-realize na connected po talaga. So yung pollution, umiikot yan, hindi lang sa isang lugar. So nakaka-apekto talaga siya sa mga fish captures at sa mga inaalaga. Yung floodings na biglaan kahit na hindi mag-typhoon, naranasan na rin po namin yan. Na-wash up po yung mga fish cages namin, na which is hindi nangyayari. Ano po talagang nangyayari natural at saka man-made na nangyayari po ngayon. Dapat po talaga may balance po para sa mga turista, hindi dahil namamasyal lang sila or dahil gusto lang po nilang makita yung beauty ng nature natin, kundi po maging partner sila sa pagprotekta at pagpanatili ng conservation ng ecosystem.
What the International Ocean Station is really is a dream for La Union, right? As La Union goes through a lot of changes, you know, a lot of exciting things are happening, but also a lot of troubling things like pollution, overdevelopment. There are people that are not involved or included in said development. So we want to hope to expand the conversation so that more people can be part of the dream and the project of making this place even better.
So you see, like all of us, we have different activities in the sea. And so if we build this floating laboratory, then you can decide how you want it to do. What are we going to do today? Yes, we're going to play. And we're going to start by making sketches, maybe for like 15 minutes. And after that, we're going to start building it.
This is a shark sensor and coffee bar for when the sharks are not here for surfers.
They are actually lack of clean drinking water. And it will be nice if they have also access. So hindi na sila kailangan bumili pa. And less plastic.
This is a floating ocean wave power plant generator. This is one of the projects that we're thinking of. And I think this is doable, you know, with a lot of scientists, Filipino scientists working abroad. We can invite them to join us here and develop, you know, technology to harness electricity from the ocean waves. For 6 years, we were able to stall the construction of the power plant. We started very few. We were only about less than 20 in the group. We asked the religious sector, the academe, the senior citizens, and the youth to join us.
Po tayo sa waterfalls, man. Our majesty place, Tangadan Falls.
This is the International Ocean Station. That's the contact if they ever need help. And it's also to detect fish in the area.
These are pilot boats.
Wow.
And this is a trash collector.
Since it's night, you can stay here, made for the fisherman. It was so hard to go fishing while studying. Many friends are still a fisherman right now. And because of them, I learned.
It's a reading shelter, so inspired by clamshells.
And poly pocket.
Poly pocket, perfect! It has a small computer inside that can store stories around the sea. Videos, any content. It can be a floating library.
Can you always stands for ocean and siyong for museum.
We have workshops po here, that's why we have tables. Those bottles na collect from the ocean will stay here and will be used for those different works or artworks na gagawin ng mga visitors.
Oh, wow!
Isa siyang turtle altar na papalutangin sa ocean. A lot of us have forgotten that we're actually connected to the land, but it's not just the land, we're also connected to the ocean. In this material symbolism to just say that nature or the turtles or the ocean is sacred can actually move us to be closer from where we are.
planning the workshop was tough because we didn't know what to expect. We didn't know what people would contribute. So it was a process of really being open and just being willing to listen to people. It's because, you know, you're hearing people's ideas. So it's very simple. They just want proper facilities.
Personally, dagat sa akin is comfort zone. Dahil sa dagat po, mga anak namin, harap namin, yun po masaya. Kikita po nila yung hanap buhay namin mag-asawa, as fishing folks. It na volunteers lang po kami, may naitutulong kami, may naikokontribute kami. Imagine yung concept po ninyo at saka yung way of livelihood namin ngayon, magka-interconnected din siya. Kaya nagkamap ako sa idea na ito. Solar Seasol Farm, aquaponics, fish observatory, may fish processing area na rin. Pati yung food stall or market. First time po namin makapag-workshop ng ganitong klaseng workshop. So, yung idea po ninyo is possible po pala.
This project would not be possible without you guys. I came with this dream of, you know, this kind of grand vision of International Ocean Station, but it can somehow sound very disconnected from the reality of people. And then you brought the reality and also your own dreams into this picture. And we hope to continue to work with you to continue to create this International Ocean Station. Now this is just the very baby stages, but hopefully this adventure just keeps growing and we can make those things a reality.
I want to take a course in a college that will help the nature. We need to work on our environment first because in the future, it's going to suffer din is us.
Simple lang naman po yung pangarap namin sa karagatan. Lalo po dito sa Laundon. Yung mapanatili lamang po yung kalinisan niya, mapanatili din yung mga different species ng isda. Para po sa gayon po, yung mga fisher folks, may mahuhuli silang isda. Hindi lang po para sa family nila, may pa-ano din sa community.
The ocean is dreaming!